Glory to Jesus. Today we are taking another break from the flow of Lent because of the importance of this man that we celebrate today. When you take away Joseph, the story of Jesus is no longer complete. Yet, not much is said about Joseph. Not much is known about Joseph. Joseph is like a background player. And when we even greet Jesus, we greet Jesus, we greet Mary, we forget Joseph. Glory to Jesus, you say honor to Mary. What about Joseph who was in the house with them? What about Joseph, the one who taught Jesus Christ to be industrious? The one who taught Jesus Christ morality? If you agree that Jesus Christ was actually a human being, if you agree that he was a human being, then we need to praise Joseph. We need to actually give Joseph the honor that he deserves. God could have done it in such a way that Jesus would be conceived in the womb of Mary and he would be born. Only Mary would have been able to take care of Joseph. That is to tell us that every child needs a father. Even if it's not his biological father, every child needs a father and a mother. Every child needs that. That's why God did not say, okay, only Mary, just take care of it. And Joseph made a lot of sacrifice. Joseph made a lot of sacrifice to be the foster father of Jesus. He was a protector. Many times God told him in a dream, rise, take the child and his mother, run. The child's life is at stake. Joseph obeyed. Joseph obeyed. This is a great man of faith. A man who believed his dreams. Most of us, when we dream of something that we don't like, something that we don't want, we woke up instantly to cast and fight that dream. We rebuke that dream. But that was not the case of Joseph. He was planning to quietly divorce Mary. And the angel was telling him in a dream, go ahead, you will have to marry this woman because she is carrying the child of the Holy Spirit. He accepted. He did not reject his dream. He accepted to be a celibate. A special kind of celibate, you know, in an attempt to play down the value of Mary, our separated brethren, non-Catholics, they always emphasize that Mary had other children, and apart from Jesus, Mary had other children. And you even see some textbooks, some CRS textbooks. Sometimes we don't go through these textbooks our children use. Some of these textbooks actually state that James and John were brothers, biological brothers of Jesus, or sons of Mary. But it is not true. It's not true. They are just relatives. So in their attempt to try to play down Mary, they emphasize that Mary had other children for Joseph. But that is not the case. Mary was a virgin before she gave birth to Jesus. While she was giving birth to Jesus, she remained a virgin. And even after giving birth to Jesus, Mary remained a virgin all through her life. So Joseph was celibate. And a special kind of celibate. A sacrificial celibate, so to say. Because it is one thing to be a celibate and live all alone by yourself and avoid any relationship or any friendship with anybody. But it is another thing to be a celibate, to be married, and to be living with a woman in the same house. Of course, I wonder how Joseph must have done it. But that was actually what happened. So we celebrate this great man today, Joseph. And as we recall the virtues of Joseph, we pray that God will bless us with those virtues. And there is one thing about Joseph that is actually very striking to me. The fact that Joseph, when he heard that Mary was with a child, he was planning to divorce her quietly, informally, to spare her the publicity. This is one thing that is lacking in our world today and lacking amongst us Christians. We have this tendency of broadcasting the ills of others. Once we begin to suspect that someone has done something bad, we cannot keep it to ourselves. We must wash the person's dirtiness outside. We are so used to gossiping. We are so used to carrying stories about others, even things that they tell us in confidence. You know, I saw a drama, quite a funny one. A lady was crying. She was feeling so sad and depressed. A friend came. A friend said, "What is the problem? Whatever it is, you can confide in me. Am I not your friend?" And then the lady said, "Oh, I missed my period and I have examinations. I don't know how to go about it." And the friend said, "Oh, it's not a big deal. Don't worry. God will see you through." This friend of hers went to tell another woman that so-and-so is pregnant. And that one also went to tell another person, so-and-so is pregnant. And she was actually the choir director or the choir mistress in the church. And so from gossip, the matter actually went up to the pastor. And then they called a meeting in the church, the meeting of the elders of the church. And they sent for this lady. And then he said, "You can no longer be the choir mistress in this church because you have not been a morally upright person. First of all, we need you to tell us, who is the father of this child you are carrying?" And she was like, "Which child? I'm not pregnant." "So how dare you say you are not pregnant?" So they called the other lady, who told her to just tell her in confidential. And they called her. They said, "Tell us what you know about this lady." And she said, "Well, you were the one who told me you missed your period now. Are you trying to deny it?" She said, "Yes, I missed my physics practical period. And I have examinations. I was worried and thinking of how am I going to write the examinations." My dear friends in Christ, we pray that we may be like Saint Joseph and not be too quick to carry the faults and the wrongs of others. Sometimes, most of those things you receive on your phone, on WhatsApp, concerning people, "Oh, scandal, this scandal," they may not be true. So take your time first before you begin to share with your contacts. May God bless His words in our hearts. And may Saint Joseph inspire us. May we emulate His virtues through Christ our Lord.